My lovely wife. We just recently got married. I got married for the second time. I got married for all the right reasons this time because she's got awesome health insurance. I'm just kidding. She's rich. Jeez. Not that fucking petty. God. I have great standards. We're a little too excited to get married, and we have a wedding planned later on this summer, and we chose to just go to the courthouse and just get everything taken care of so we have the satisfaction of being married. Now, when you're there, you do the legit, you know, vows or whatever that you need to repeat, things like that, and put the ring on their finger and stuff like that. And I do my part because the man always goes first, then the woman second. She puts the ring on my finger. And the magistrate says, repeat after me. And he says her name. Says, I take you, Christopher Dyke, to be my lawfully wedded wife. So I turn to the magistrate and I was like, dude, is this a Dyke thing? Really? What the fuck, bro? Now, we made it past it, even though my wife wouldn't stop fucking laughing the whole time. She was doing the rest of the vows. You know how embarrassing it is. I mean, a wedding, you know, the time that you get married is supposed to be magical and sweet and emotional for a woman. And the whole time she's like, till death do us part. Oh my God. My wife. For richer or poorer. Fucking 75% of the vows that she's saying to me, she's looking at the fucking ground because she can't stop laughing. Because she's marrying a dyke, which I didn't know this, ladies and gentlemen. And now I'm actually rethinking marriage because come to find out, before we even met and started dating, she was about ready to throw in the towel on dating and become a lesbian. So I'm on to her fucking game because my last name's Dyke. She's easing herself into it. Sneaky fucker. Nah, we have a great marriage. We love each other dearly. She lets me pick on her. But the reason why she lets me pick on her is because the day we got married, we, consummated our marriage, you know, so to speak. And we're laying in bed, obviously. Not even 3 minutes after consummation period ends. Mind you, there's still no clothes on. She fucking farts for the first time of our entire relationship. The day we get married, not just a few minutes after we got finished having relations. She goes, I'm sorry, it got built up. Oh, it got built up. It's not like I was pushing it back or anything like that. I wasn't messing around with that spot. Jesus. And now she won't stop. Fucking farting. So yeah, nobody ever told me that. That's what you get to look forward to in marriage. It's like, oh, be careful, you'll get fat and they'll get complacent and they'll do this and this and this in marriage. Nobody has ever told me, oh, be careful, because once you get married, she's gonna just keep fucking, she'll be dropping some deuces around you, dude. Like even before we got married, I never even knew she pooped. She learned how. Jesus Christ. She would shut the door and turn the fan on and not tell me. I was like, oh, I need to go pee. I was like, holy shit. I was like, baby, what did you eat? She's lactose intolerant too, so. And then she'd blame me. Hey, you're the one that wanted ice cream last night. Because apparently that's marriage, where you get to blame people for your flatulence and bowel movements and stuff. You wouldn't stop tickling me, so I farted. Is that your fucking fighting mechanism? It's just like, is that your comeback? You know, I throw a right hook, you fart or something. Could you goo? Get away from me! Don't tickle me! Okay, we're sidetracked again. Oh man, but I love being married. I love the fact that I'm with an older woman. I love that because when we were first starting to date, we weren't obviously living together or anything like that. But some of the things that as a younger man that I would do just as my everyday chores, just, you know, living as a lonely guy, would be twisted to an older woman into something sexual. I never knew that. For instance, one day she calls me and says, hey, what are you up to? I was like, oh, I'm just cleaning the apartment. You know, I'm cooking lunch right now. I got laundry going. I'm going to clean the bathroom here shortly. And there was a pause, followed by an, oh, baby, tell me more. It's like, hell yeah, I started a 1-900 Mr. Clean number. It's like, yeah, you like that shit? I'll get down and scrub this floor real good, baby. Yeah, I got a pack of rubber gloves to do these dishes. Yeah. I'm going to scrub that toilet so hard, you'll be begging for more. Comment. Yeah. Fucking. And she gets me, too, sometimes. Because we have... People say what they say about marriage, about how your sex life falters. It hasn't yet, so I'm grateful for that. But she throws some weird things at me because she used to be a cheerleader back in high school. And now she's also, like, a coach for, like, some girl sport or something. I think volleyball, I believe it is. I don't pay attention when she talks, but she's been bringing that into the bedroom. Not the volleyball girls, I wish, but she's come up with cheers while we're making love. It's a little weird. She thinks it's to coach me, but it's not helping. You know, it's like, 1, 2, 3, 4, do me good and make me sore, you know, or 5, 6, 7, 8, if you're not good, go masturbate. She's in the doghouse right now because she looked me dead in the eye one day while we were in the middle of doing it and goes, 2, 4, 6, 8, ejaculate and make me late. So needless to say, she slept on the couch that day. I ain't falling for that shit.